Right? The minute the soul comes now, the body has two functions. You can hear, you talk, you think, all these things now back the way you were. قال فيأتيه ملكان. Now once the ruh comes back to the body, two angels come. فيجلسان. He spoke about them. And he asked them, they asked him, من ربك؟ فيقول ربي الله. المؤمن. من ربك؟ الله. There is narration, and I don't know the extent of it. So I'm just saying it as is. Don't take it from me as has an extent. So you say, you know, Muhammad bin Yahya said so. Lakin, I have heard of it, and I wasn't able to find it anywhere. So if anybody finds it, please let me know. Lakin, one of our shuyukh, rahmatullahi alayhi, told us once that Sayyidina Umar al-Faruq, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in the su'al, when the malaika come and they set him up, he asks them, who is your Lord? Not they ask him, he asks them in return. So the questioning now is reversed. Lakin there's no dalil that I have on this. So if you found the dalil, if you find the dalil, please let me know. Now, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now, he says then, فَيَقُولَنِ لَهُ مَا دِينُكَ. What is your deen? Deen ya al-Islam. إِنَّ دِينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. فَيَقُولَنْ لَهُ. Then they ask him third question. مَا هَذَا الرَّجُلُ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ. What is the story of this man that was sent to you? فَيَقُولْ هُوَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم. Is he رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَيَقُولَنْ. This is the fourth question. Al-Hadith Sahih. Sometimes we miss the first question, but it's important. يَقُولَنْ لَهُ وَمَا عِلْمُكَ. How did he get this knowledge? Where did he get your knowledge from? وَمَا عِلْمُكَ. Where did you get your knowledge from? That's what he says. فَيَقُولُ قَرَأْتُ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ فَآمَنْتُ بِهِ وَصَدَّقْتُ. My ilm, my source is Kitab Allah. For me and you, not only for him. Where did you get your knowledge from? How many times you review with the Book of Allah? What is your relationship with the Book of Allah? Where do you get your aqeedah and definitive knowledge from? What is the status of the Qur'an in your house? Ya Rabbi, inna qawmi ittakhadu hadha al-Qur'an mahjura. Is it mahjur? Or are you always working with the Qur'an? Ma ilmuk. Where is your knowledge from? Kitabullah. The book. Where is your, they're going to ask him and tell him, give him? And you know, you're coming, it's a scary situation. Ma ilmuka. You present the book. I have the Book of Allah with me. Take it. There's nothing I can do. Book of Allah, Book of Allah. فَآمَنْتُ بِهِ وَصَدَّقْتُ. I believed in it. I read it. I believed in it. فَيُنَادِي مُنَادًا فِي السَّمَاءِ. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, someone, a caller from heaven, by the order of Allah will call, أَنْ صَدَقَ عَبْدِي. My slave has said the truth. فَأَفْرِشُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ. Put him a carpet from Jannah. Look, where's that? In Qabr, still in Qabr. Put him a carpet in Qabr from Jannah. وَأَلْبِسُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ. And give him garments from Jannah. Allah. Not only now you'll be now having, you know, things from Jannah under you, لَنَا. Even your garment from Jannah. Put your clothing from Jannah. وَافْتَحُوا لَهُ بَابًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. And open for him a door, direct gate from his grave to where? To Jannah. Some people say when you go and visit Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, how come, you know, you're staying here? They don't understand that you're sitting next to Jannah. Jannah, hadith sahih. Hadith sahih. Between my manbar and my sight. I like to say sight. He's alive, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alive. By every definition that you can think of and definitions that you can't think of. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself told us. Not only any piece of Jannah, but an oasis of Jannah. Nothing is equal to the place. Nothing on earth is equal to the place that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the greatest of places Allah created, is the place that touches his body sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anyway. So when they open up this gate from this grave now to Jannah, يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says, فيأتيه من روحها وطيبها. He gets this Jannah breeze from Jannah. In the grave now you're thinking this is closed up and all that. No, he's getting breeze. And where is this breeze coming from? Oh, the breeze from Jannah. Look at that. Huh? ويفسح له في قبره مد بصره. And his grave will be expanded. What? The extent of your sight. Yani not 1 meter by 1 meter anymore. You're sitting, if you can stand up on a horizontal plane, not on an earth plane, because earth is oval. But if you were to sit on a horizontal plane and you look straight at the horizon, how far can you see? This is how far then that away, that rawdah in qabr and that to that believer. All this, and the breeze is coming from where? From everywhere, from Jannah. وَيَأْتِيهِ. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam does not stop here. He says, وَيَأْتِيهِ. And then something will come to him. وَفِي رِوَايَ يُمَثَّلُ لَهُ. Yani, something will come and symbolize a man. A man will come to him. يُمَثَّل. So you may take it like the brother mentioned, an angel. Or the deed itself comes embodied in the form of a man. Whichever it is. Why you say, well, يعني why does a man come? لأنه القبر what? الوحشة, بيت الوحشة. القبر is lonely. Huh? So Allah sends someone to entertain you sitting there so you have someone to talk to you and all these things. You're not left alone. You have the Jannah coming there, the breeze, you're sitting and talking and all this. So you have some person, حسن الوجه, a man with beautiful face, يعني نوراني. نوراني face. حسن الثياب. Garments are beautiful, clean, nice. طيب الريح, smell is beautiful, that man comes. فيقول, this man when he comes to him, he's in the grave, he's, Assalamu alaikum, what are you doing here? فيقول أبشر, he tells him, أبشر بالذي, أبشر, have I'm bringing you the good tidings. أبشر برضوان من الله. I'm bringing you the good tidings of the pleasure of Allah. That is, that he has upon you. وَجَنَّاتٍ فِيهَا نَعِيمٌ مُقِيمٌ. Not Jannah. Many, many Jannat. فِيهَا نَعِيمٌ. Everlasting pleasure. Not one Jannah. Jannat. Many, 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 many Jannat. Subhanallah. أَلَّذِي هَذَا يَوْمُكَ الَّذِي كُنْتَ تُوعَدُهُ. This man tells him, this is the day you've been promised. That dead man, the man supposedly died, فَيَقُولُ لَهُ, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, he tells him, وَأَنْتَ فَبَشَّرَكَ اللَّهُ بِخَيْرٍ. You, may Allah give you good tidings also. He doesn't know that says his name. You give me good tidings, may Allah give you good tidings as well. So we can learn from that when someone makes dua for you, make dua for them. Somebody gives you, make dua for them. Maybe because you make dua for them, Allah will forgive you. Not because of you, maybe you're not worthy, but because you're trying to be generous, to make dua for someone else. So you know what? Allah is more generous than both of you. He'll forgive both of you because of that. Of course. Okay. قال وأنت فبشرك الله بخير. You, who are you? من أنت? Who are you? May Allah give you good tidings also. فوجهك الوجه يجيء بالخير. Your face brings good news. You know, you, subhanAllah, like you see some people, their faces bring the good news. Yani tell me about who you are. He's trying to tell me who you are so I can reward you. I try to, at least I'll make dua for you if I can't do anything. Huh? Dua for you. He says, فيقول, that man says, أنا عملك الصالح. I am your good deeds. Symbolized now in a man. Then he says, فوالله, by Allah, ما علمتك إلا شريعا في طاعة الله. I've always known you rushing to the obedience of Allah. بطيئا عن معصية الله. Slow from going to disobedience of Allah. فجزاك الله خيرا. May Allah give you خير. Look, your good deeds, what does he say? By Allah, I have always known you to rush to the obedience of Allah. يعني when the door is open for sadaqah or zakah, you are the first one. When the door is open for majlis ilm, you are the first one. When any opportunity comes for siyam, you're running. When opportunity comes to help people, you're always running. فَوَاللَّهِ مَا عَلِمْتُكَ إِلَّا شَرِيعًا. You were always in a hurry. Whenever an opportunity of doing good comes up, you're always, you always rush to it. and you're always slow.